Good morning, everyone, and welcome to today's Cup of Joe. It is the 22nd of May, Friday, and so our last Cup of Joe for the week here. And let's ask the Lord to be with us as we continue to be guided by Him on this Friday in the Easter season. In the name of the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit, amen. Father in heaven, we thank You for all the blessings in life. We ask that in the challenges of life, You would help us to walk through them with You. Not to cast You aside, but to walk closer with You. Father, we thank You for everything You do, for the gift of family. Ask that You would bless our school, bless our church, and bless all of the people in our town and in our city here. Ask that You would guide us and help us to be holy, and to always use each Friday every week to be drawn closer to You and enter into Your passion each and every Friday. Lord, we ask all this, and we ask for the prayers of all the angels and saints in heaven, our big brothers and sisters in the faith, especially for our Mother Mary in heaven, for her prayers. And we ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, amen. Now today, we'll briefly and quickly go through the first 18 chapters. We're in the 18th chapter of Acts of the Apostles here, and so let's do it here as quick as we can. Chapter 1, Ascension, which we'll celebrate together this weekend on Sunday. Chapter 2, Pentecost. Chapter 3, the crippled man. Chapter 4, Boldness. The 5th chapter is escaping from prison. 6th chapter is the deacon. 7th chapter is Stephen. 8th chapter is Philip. 9th chapter is Saul's conversion. 10th chapter is Cornelius. 11th chapter is Gentiles. 12th chapter is Herod. 13th chapter is Paul and Barnabas. 14th chapter is the strength and humility of Paul and Barnabas. 15th chapter is Jerusalem and the council. And the 16th chapter is Paul and Silas. 17th chapter is Athens. 18th chapter is Corinth. And that's where we are continuing working at today. And Paul is in Corinth. And I want to draw something out that caught my attention this morning as I was praying with this and looking at this. So it says there's this big instance that happens between Paul and the folks, and the kind of the leaders in Corinth, the proconsul, which is the kind of leader of the area, not a Christian, not a Jew, just a Roman citizen or a Greek citizen, I guess, who is just in charge of the area. Doesn't really care about the instance, doesn't really care about what's happening. He just wants to keep things calmed down. The battle between the Jews and the Christians is going on, and the Jews don't want the Christians to be doing what they're doing, and the Christians are trying to push for all of this. And Gallio, the guy in charge of the land, doesn't really care. He just doesn't want them fighting, pushes it all aside, kind of doesn't make a big deal out of it. But then it says, Paul remained for quite some time, and after saying farewell to the brothers, he sailed for Syria. So back to Antioch in Syria, together with Priscilla and Aquila. At Cenchreae, he shaved his head because he had taken a vow. And at Cenchreae, he shaved his head and took a vow. So that's kind of an interesting thing. And I want to talk about that. What does that mean? Well, Paul had spent a year and a half in Corinth. It's a long time. And I think what many scripture scholars, and there's a lot of arguments for this, but what I've come to believe and what I think is most reasonable is why Paul shaved his head when he left Corinth is that when he got to Corinth, he knew it was going to be trouble. He knew it was going to be difficult. Corinth is a port city. It was hugely traveled. There was all kinds of debauchery. I always kind of think of Corinth as the Vegas of its day, right? There was a lot of debauchery there. There was a lot of things going on that probably shouldn't have been going on. And he spent a year and a half in Corinth working with the people there and drawing them to Christ. And it was challenging. And so I think when he started there, what he did is he made a vow, which is usually called a Nazarite vow. A Nazarite vow is that basically asking for a specific thing. This is John the Baptist was a Nazarite. Samson was a Nazarite. There were other Nazarites throughout the Old Testament. And Paul, I think, in that year and a half, really took the vow that he's going to enter into this deeply. He didn't cut his hair for that year and a half. So he had some pretty motley hair, I'm sure, after a year and a half. And did that as a sign of kind of penance and a sign of, Lord, help me to enter into this time and help the people who are here. And so he did that, and after he left Corinth, after a year and a half, he finally was able to cut his hair. So he shaved his head and cut his hair at Cenchreae and did just that. And that was kind of what it was. And I bring that up today because I want to talk about something that I don't think gets talked about a whole heck of a lot in the church today. And that is Fridays throughout the church year. It has been understood by many people that before the Second Vatican Council, no one was supposed to eat meat on Fridays. Not just during Lent, but every Friday of the year, the thing was to not eat meat on Fridays. It's just a simple sign of penance throughout the year to remind ourselves of the Passion of Christ, that people tend to like meat. And so it was a sign to kind of remind ourselves, like, I'm going to give up something on Friday, which is meat, church working together. When it works together, things work really well. When it doesn't work together, things don't work well. And so that was the idea, is let's all work together on something and not eat meat together. And I think it was understood by most people that that was abrogated, that that was cut out completely after the Second Vatican Council, which isn't necessarily true. The church never said to stop the penance of not eating meat on Friday. It never said don't do it anymore. It never said stop doing this. The thought was is that it should continue, and that we would always do something on Friday to remind ourselves of Christ's passion, that he died for us on this day. And so that's why we kind of enter into that on Friday. We always remind ourselves of Christ's passion on Friday, which is why we always celebrate the Easter Sunday celebration every Sunday, not just on Easter, but every Sunday, and why we want to come together as a church to celebrate that. And God willing, we'll be able to sometime soon. So I would encourage you to consider taking up that practice, which was done before the Second Vatican Council and never officially stopped, just kind of, I think it was assumed that it stopped. I'd encourage you to not eat meat on Fridays, to choose to not eat meat on Fridays, because the church never really said, don't do that anymore. And if that's a thing that, you know what, I'm going to eat meat on Fridays, there's Fridays where it just works that, you know, I'm eating, I have to eat meat for one reason or another, do something. Give up something every Friday. And maybe it's I'm not going to have sweets on Friday. Maybe it's I'm not going to eat between meals on Friday. Something. To always remind ourselves of the act of suffering that Christ went through for you and for me on every given Friday. And let's do that. Let's just take that up as a parish together. It can be the no eating meat on Friday. That's a good thing. It's kind of neat to do something to know the whole church is doing something together. You can do that. And if you don't do that and something comes up and you aren't able to do that, find something. No sweets, no something that I enjoy on Fridays to remind myself of what Christ has done for you, Christ has done for me. As Paul did at Cenchreae, he cut his hair because for a year and a half he didn't cut his hair taking that Nazarite vow, asking God to strengthen him and keep him strong to help people know and love the Lord. Let's do the same in our own lives. Just small little things we can do to remind ourselves that what the Lord has done for us, and that we might do those same little things for other people, asking the Lord to take that little suffering we enter into and help other people come to know him. And that's our cup of Joe for today. And I'll ask the Lord to continue to guide and bless you. May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And may today's cup of Joe be your means of finding joy in the world on this Friday. Let's find that joyful penance to enter into so that we can help other souls come to know the Lord. God bless you.